Thank you, Frank. Let's keep it moving. In the heavyweight division, we've got a very, very intriguing fight here between Britain's hard-hitting former WBA heavyweight champion Daniel Dubois against America's loud, outspoken, unbeaten and brash Jarrell Big Baby Miller. This fight is brought to you for Riyadh season by the NEC, the General Entertainment Authority. Frank Warren on behalf of Queensbury Promotions, Spencer Brown's Gold Star Promotions and Seller in association with Salita Promotions. Now, before we speak to the fighters, let's hear from the promoters. I'll bring in one of the hardest working promoters out there in Dimitri Salita. Jarrell Miller is a guy that you have been backing for a long time now. He's right behind you there as well. Big chance to remind the world what Big Baby's about.
Thank you. First of all, we're very grateful to participate in this event, and I'm very grateful to His Excellency and to Queensbury. It's been a great honor to work with you guys. I've been saying this for a long time. Jarrell has the skills, the personality to be one of the best heavyweights in the world. This is a big step in that direction, and I believe he's going to be explosive, sensational, exciting, and victorious on December 23rd.
How do you see this fight going? Because Daniel Dubois, you know, in his last fight, he boxed Usyk. There's a lot of controversy around that fight. Jarrell Miller, I don't know if he's boxed at that level yet, but tell us how you break down this fight.
I think Daniel Dubois is a very talented fighter. He has shown that he's hungry, he has a lot of power, he wants to win, but Jarrell's tenacity, his size, his power, I believe is going to be his key to victory. And Jarrell, with an impressive victory, fits himself right in to the big fights with Anthony Joshua, the winner of Tyson Fury versus Usyk, Deontay Wilder, etc. He is an elite heavyweight, and I believe it's just a matter of time until he reestablishes himself as that, and December 23rd is a big step in that direction.
Thank you, Dimitri. We'll come back to you when we're talking about Otto Valin. I'll bring in Frank Warren here. You are Daniel Dubois' promoter. This is Daniel's first fight since that Oleksandr Usyk fight, and you would be forgiven for maybe an easy touch, but in front of you, you've got a 300-pound pressure fighter who's unbeaten and coming to take Daniel's head off. Tell us your thoughts.
Look, Daniel needs a fight. He needs a tough fight. He's got to go out there and show everybody what he's about. You know, he was that much away from becoming world champion. You know, I'm not going all to the controversy again, but he can punch. And there's been some doubters out there. We believe in him. He believes in himself. So he's got to get out there now and show what he's all about. He's a young man. And this is, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I'm with the greatest respect to all you fellas. You know, a lot of them are getting older. He's a young guy. He's got a big opportunity here to on this stage to show that he can do it and what he's all about. And I've got faith in him that he'll do it. And obviously you're going to speak to him yourself and ask him. But he cannot afford now to slip up. This is it. This is his big moment in time. And we're going to find out what Daniel Dubois is all about.
Thank you, Frank. Well, let's bring in Jarrell Big Baby Miller. We are going to find out what Daniel Dubois is all about on December 23rd. Are we going to find out what you're all about?
First of all, I want to say, you know, we got to wake this crowd up. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you, Brother Turkey, for putting on this event. Frank Warren, George, for working diligently behind the scene and making it happen. Brother Spencer Brown, for really putting this together. And thank you, Daniel Dubois, for being the dummy to sign the contract, because I'm going to beat your ass. Listen, man, proof is in the pudding. When I talk that shit, but I back it up. Every time. So whether it's kickboxing or boxing, I'm going in there and I'm going to rip his head off. You know, there's a saying we have in New York. I mean, if you don't like vulgarness, cover your ear. We smell bitch in them. And once the bitch is in you, it ain't going nowhere. He quit against Joy Joyce. He got beat up and knocked out by a jab by Usyk. And those are small guys. I mean, Joy Joyce is big, but he ain't big baby big. So I'm telling you something. When you find a mean guy like me that's throwing 80 punches around, got a good chin, don't quit, come forward. I'm kicking his ass, and I'm sending him to early retirement, plain and simple.
Okay, well, let's... Let's actually bring in Daniel Dubois here. Daniel, you've just heard a lot of comments there. He says he's going to kick your ass. He's talked about doing all sorts of things to you on December 23rd. How does that sound?
Excited for it, you know. This is it. Big time boxing, baby. I want to chop that tree down, and that's what I'm planning to do.
Jarrell, what do you think of Daniel Dubois?
Man. If shit had a twin, it'd be his face. It's plain and simple. I mean, listen, bro. Like I said before, we could talk the talk and walk the walk. I talk and I back it up. Like I said, I think that his new trainer put the battery in his back, try to motivate him to get in there with the likes of me. You know what I mean? He was scared to fight Joseph Parker. I heard Joseph Parker moved too much for him, so he don't want to chase him around. So he thought because I'm inactive, he's going to fight a big guy like me. But I come forward, and I'm just mean, hungry. And like I said before, there's nothing he's going to do to me that's going to bother me. I'm going to hit him with everything in the kitchen sink, and I'm going to send him back to his trainer, and I'm going to tell him, I told you so. So listen, plain and simple, come December 23rd, I'm going to kick your stuttery ass. Watch.
Daniel, any response to that? That's
bring it on. Bring it on. Bring it on. I'm ready for it. I'm motivated for this fight. And, you know, after that fight and the emotions that that fight stirred up in me, I'm up for it. And I want to really go to
gonna
war for this
You're going to make him
one.
Pay? Hey? You're going to make him pay for it?
Oh, yeah.
Good. Good. That's what we want.
His promoter got to hype him up because he over there, he's stealing a bag of chips over there, boy. Listen, man, I'm telling you right now, man, I'm going to fry your ass. Anybody, once I kick his behind, I'm going to buy everybody fish and chips in here. Bet my word on that. And Frank, we're going to talk long term. Don't worry, after I cook your boy. I feel bad for you for putting that money behind that dude. It's a wrap.
We will see.
Jarrell, I've just got one more for you because you have a kind of hostility with a number of heavyweights. Mm-hmm. I've seen recent things with Deontay Wilder. Of course, you were scheduled at one point to fight Anthony Joshua. Mm-hmm. Do you have anything to say to anyone else up here?
Oh, they can all kiss my black ass, Deontay and AJ. I don't like none of them motherfuckers, you know what I'm trying to say? But one thing I can tell you is that after I finished with Dubois, I definitely want Manuel Charque because he got that belt. Them dudes got losses, and there ain't nothing over there with for them belts right now. But I tell you one thing, though. We all know for a fact that AJ don't want no smoke with Deontay.
Shut the fuck up.
And even though...
Start with
even,
me, you know.
Even though...
Yeah. Listen,
Miller, don't start with me.
Even though...
You know I'll come
listen,
over there and
listen,
slap you, and I see you brought your mom here again.
I almost kicked your ass last time.
I see you brought your mom here again because you need a rampage.
Boy, shut up. You're not built like that. But like I was saying, we all know that AJ don't want no smoke with Deontay. As much as I don't like Deontay, I know Deontay will put that motherfucker in the grave. So let's make... I'll make it easy for you. Either you can fight Deontay and go to the grave, or fight me and go to the hospital. Either way, you can get your ass whooped. So pick your poison. So let's stop all that talking. Take Eddie Hearn Thumb out your ass and pick somebody that really can fight. Either me or Deontay, one of us Americans, whoop your ass. So stop running over your English muffin.
You are not doing
listen,
nothing.
Bro,
to
listen, bro. You softening baby.
You are not
shit.
Doing nothing to me. Watch your mouth.
You let my little cousin
Miller,
Eddie Reese.
Watch your mouth.
You softening baby.
Watch your mouth.
Shit.
I'll come over there.
Stop running from me. Stop running from Deontay.
Mouth.
Man the fuck up and fight somebody with a heartbeat, bro. Shut up.
But Daniel Dubois got to stop this. We can't have it, Daniel. Tell him. You're not going to let him do this, Daniel.
Daniel, anything to say? Not right now, but we're going to keep things moving. Thank you very much, Jarrell Miller.
You're welcome.
Joshua, we're going to start talking about your fight now as well. Of course, one of the co-main events on December 23rd pits the former two-time unified world heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua, not against Jarrell Miller. He is taking on
fuck
Otto,
Jarrell Miller.
Otto Valin.
Man, kiss my black ass.
But I do think he will fight Miller one day.
You ain't my promoter to judge what I'm going to do in my career.
And he is taking on Otto Valin on December 23rd. The fight is brought to you for Riyadh season by the NEC, the General Entertainment Authority, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Boxing, Frank Warren's Queensbury Promotions, Spencer Brown's Gold Star Promotions, AJ Boxing, and Seller in association with Salita Promotions. Let's bring in Dimitri Salita. Otto Valin, your man, is in a tremendous position right now in the rankings, and he's got this chance now again against Anthony Joshua here. Tell us what you're thinking about this fight.
Well, Otto Valin has shown his world-class ability versus his incredible fighter Tyson Fury. He stayed busy. He's been working with his excellent trainer, one of the best teachers in the game, Joey Gamache, perfecting his craft and coming off his last win against Murad Gassiev, which was very impressive. I believe that Otto has the skills, the confidence to win this big fight.
Thank you, Dimitri. Let's bring in Eddie Hearn here, Anthony Joshua's promoter. Eddie, you have been with Anthony every step of the way. And now the next fight is against a southpaw who's coming off a great win. How are you feeling about this one?
I think it's a very tough fight. I think it's a great fight. Hello to Dimitri, who, you know, fighters should know, like Otto Valin. Dimitri Salita has been trying to land this fight for years against Anthony Joshua. After every fight that AJ's had, Dimitri phones me. What about Otto Valin? You know, we saw him in a great fight with Tyson Fury. I think not a lot of people know even about his victory on the road against Gassiev in Russia just a few weeks ago. It was a massive win for him. We respect him. He's well schooled. He's 6 foot six. He's a good southpaw. But we see something different from AJ now. You know, I think the plan at the start of this year was to box three times. When he was unified world heavyweight champion, the politics, the mandatories led to a lot of inactivity. He boxed in April. He boxed in August. And now he boxes in December. I think, you know, and I'm definitely biased, but I believe that there's the best chapter to write yet in the story of Anthony Joshua. You know, what he's given to this sport. He sold out arenas at Wembley Stadium, Millennium Stadium, Madison Square Gardens, Riyadh before. This is his third fight in Saudi Arabia. He's changed the complete face of boxing. And it's a pleasure to go back. And you know, when we had the approach from His Excellency to bring Anthony Joshua to Saudi Arabia, it was a fight and a challenge that he wants to take. He wants to become world heavyweight champion again. I believe he can do it. And I think you're going to see a destructive performance from him. And I like what I see up here at the press conference. You know, no games, no mucking around. Business on December 23rd, move forward. We know there's another great heavyweight there in Deontay Wilder. That's a massive fight to potentially bring to Saudi Arabia in 2024. Filip Hrgović down there, the IBF number one. Otto Wallin is IBF number two. This lines up everything for Anthony Joshua, one of the biggest fights of his career. And as I said, the greatest chapter in the story of Anthony Joshua yet to write. And I can't wait to see him shine on December 23rd.
Thank you very much, Eddie Hearn. Let's bring in Otto Wallin here. I mean, Otto, as Eddie mentioned there, you've got that win over Murat Gassiev, which maybe went under the radar a bit, but it was a tremendous win. Your tail must be high right now. You must have all the confidence in the world heading into this fight.
Yeah, I want to say thank you to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for putting on this show. It's really unbelievable what they've done in 1 week. With all these fighters, this is a huge event, and I'm so happy to be part of it. So thank you very much, and thanks to Queensberry and Frank Warren that we dealt with. We got the call 1 week ago. My manager Jolene and I, we spoke about this fight. We thought it made sense. We went back and forth with Joshua's side. We came to a conclusion in 2 days maybe. And so it was an easy fight to make for us. And I'm so happy. I just coming off the great win with Gassiev. It was 5-6 weeks ago now. I did not expect to fight once more this year, but this is really amazing. I'm coming off of that win. I'm in a great position. I'm a promotional free agent. I'm ranked number two with the IBF. So I'm really on top of the world. Getting this fight, I'm so ready for it. I've been waiting for it for a long time. And I'm just so happy and blessed to be in this position.
You've boxed before in the amateurs. Anthony Joshua won that fight. You've sparred countless rounds as well. Can you take anything away from what you already learned about Anthony Joshua?
Well, I think we both have a good idea of each other. I think that I fought him when I first started boxing, pretty much. I didn't have many fights. He didn't have many fights. We fought. I lost a close decision. We fought again a couple years after, England versus Sweden. He won a close decision again. Then we sparred in 2016 before he fought Charles Martin. And I think, honestly, Joshua, he was on his way up. He's a very good fighter. He was a very good fighter at that time also. And, you know, I pretty much feel like he had his peak maybe around 2018. Joshua, he deserves a lot of respect. He's done a lot for himself. He comes from humble beginnings and really conquered the division for some time. But now I feel like he's on his way down, on his way out, and I'm going to help him with that, and I'm going to win this fight.
All right, well, let's bring in former two-time unified world heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua. Anthony, you are an iconic night, a historic night. You're no stranger to these sorts of nights. Tell us your feelings heading into this one.
Why isn't Eddie asking me questions? You're my promoter.
Eddie, would you like to ask Anthony a question?
Thank you. AJ, a massive moment for you, 6 weeks out.
Yep.
People talking about you've peaked, people talking about this might be...
People talking about our peaks have never even seen what a peak looks like in their whole career, so I don't know what they're talking about, number one. Secondly, I want to thank His Highness Turkey and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for putting a phenomenal card together. And I'm looking forward to delivering my message to Otto Wallin on December 23rd.
Obviously, this time around, short notice, three fights in 1 year. That was the plan when we set off for 2023.
Yeah,
you're going to deliver that, and it could lead to a huge 2024. But everybody talking about future fights, just purely focused on Otto Wallin, December 23rd.
Yeah. I can't predict the future, but I know where I want to go, I know what I want to do, and I'm sticking to that plan. I set out a plan at the start of this year, and I'm sticking to that. I'm a man of my word. I stand firm on what I believe, and I believe I'm going to be three-time heavyweight champion of the world. And my first stop to that in getting in the rankings is putting on a demolishing job against Otto Wallin.
And finally, sorry, Dev, finally,
crack on.
Your third fight in Saudi Arabia, back to Riyadh. I know every time you've been, it's been an incredible
phenomenal
experience, incredible Riyadh season. We saw a breathtaking production, an event with Fury against Ngannou.
Yeah.
Excited to get back to the kingdom.
100%. When my family heard we was going back to Saudi, phones started ringing off. When can we get tickets? When can we book flights? They get treated real nice when they go there. I'm focused on my fight, of course, but my whole family, my community is going to be out there. There's going to be 100 of us strong, and it's going to be a really good time to be in Saudi Arabia. So if this is the first time you're hearing it, make sure you get booked up to head out to Saudi Arabia. December 23rd, it's going to be big, and I don't think we've ever seen a card like this before.
And just definitely finally, when we sat down in that meeting with His Excellency, just on Monday night, the vision that we saw, the passion that we saw for boxing, something that we all share.
100%. So this isn't a one-stop shop. This is what I like about the vision, is that there's a map, a roadmap with checkpoints, and I can't wait to get to the final destination. So as I said, this is my first stop. And December 23rd, I'll deliver that message, and I'll be on my way again onto the next bigger and better opportunity in 2024. I'm fully focused on this fight. I'm determined to win, and I'm determined to get back to my peak, if that's what they want to call it.
Thank you, Anthony. Thank you, Eddie. I think all those questions I had written down here anyway, Eddie, so I think we're good. I think we covered it. Let's talk about the co-main event on December 23rd. A fight between two former world heavyweight champions, the long-reigning former WBC world heavyweight champion Deontay Wilder taking on former WBO world heavyweight champion Joseph Parker. Now, the fight is brought to you for Riyadh season by the NEC, the General Entertainment Authority, Frank Warren on behalf of Queensbury Promotions, Spencer Brown's Gold Star Promotions and Seller in association with Bomb Squad and Duco Events. Now, firstly, I'm going to bring in Shelley Finkel here, the longtime manager of Deontay Wilder. Shelley, great to have you. Fans have been crying out for the return of Deontay Wilder, and it's finally here on a big, big stage.
If anyone knows me, they know I do not speak long. My fighters do the speaking in the ring. Evander Holyfield, just before the Buster Douglas fight, said to me, "Shelley, how come you don't talk on loud like some other people?" I said, "They don't pay me for that, they pay you." And he went out and did the job with Buster Douglas. There was no reason for me to speak. This incredible card, we should all thank His Excellency for putting it together with, of course, the promoters here, Matchroom and Queensbury. When you look at what everything up here is, there's nothing I could say that would top this. So I will turn it back over to you.
Thank you very much, Shelley Finkel. Let's bring in Joseph Parker. Joseph, you had a very clear mission statement at the Battle of the Baddest, at the event just a few weeks ago in Riyadh. You wanted to look good, you wanted to get the win, and you wanted to get out in December. Tick, tick, tick. Here you are. Your reward is Deontay Wilder. Tell us your thoughts.
Firstly, thank you to those involved for putting on this event. Excellency Spencer Brown, Queensbury, trainers Andy Lee, George Locker for the work that we've done so far. Big man Tyson Fury for all his help. And we've made decision at the beginning of the year to keep busy, and this is the fourth fight in the year, and it's a fight that really excites me. I'm excited for this fight. You know, throughout my career, I've never went away from big fights and big opportunity, and this fight with Wilder, I'm ready for it. You know, I know we're here doing what we need to do, but I can't wait to get back into camp and put in work for this fight. I respect Wilder. Respect Malik Scott as trainer and everything that they've done in boxing, but he is in my way. I know what I can do, and I'm here to win.
And Joseph, you have been in camps with Tyson Fury, who was preparing for Deontay Wilder. What have you taken from those camps, if anything?
You know, I rely on Andy Lee, my trainer, to give me advice and to come up with a plan, but Tyson has a lot of advice as well and knowledge on Deontay Wilder, being a person to beat him, also fighting him 3 times. So I'm going to lean on Tyson Fury in this camp.
Well, look, one of Tyson's advantages was he was just so big. He may be 50 pounds heavier at times. What are your advantages over Deontay Wilder?
So you're going to see December 23. I feel like in my career, sort of went down a bit, but I got a spark back, you know, and I'm going to come in with a lot of movement, a lot of speed. What was that?
Lights out.
Okay.
Nice. Said lights out.
For you.
Okay, thank you, Joseph. Let's bring in Deontay Wilder. Deontay Wilder, it's as I said to Shelley, it's been so long since we've seen you. I think we've seen about 3 minutes in a few years. You must be so ready to come back and show the world what you can do. Tell us.
It's been a journey. First off, hello everyone. It's been a journey for me. I'm very excited to be here today. What a magnificent card that we have. We have so many warriors on this card, you know. It's overwhelming to be in the same room with so many other fighters, you know. Some you done had in camp, some you done competed against, and some you're looking forward to in the future to compete against. And it's just a blessing to be able to have so many promoters to come together, you know, Queensberry Promotion, Matchroom, and last but not least, Your Excellency. I appreciate you guys so much, you know, and the staff, and put this magnificent card together. And I'm just ready to go, you know. When people come to see heavyweight boxing, they come to see excitement. But most of all, they come to see knockouts. And one thing for sure, you know, when I come, that's what I come to deliver, you know. And come December 23rd, I'm coming to do the same thing. I'm on the same mission, you know, to regain my title back and to unify the division. That's my main goal. I got everything I want to need in life. But to come back and to finish what I started is going to mean everything to me. To just put that little icing on the cake with everything else that I've accomplished, the statue that I have, and many more things that will come in the future.
What do you think of Joseph Parker? This is a fight that was talked about a few years ago when you were WBC world champion, he was WBO world champion. It could have been a unification at that time. You were linked to fight then. What do you think of him?
Well, many times throughout my career, I didn't have the opportunity to have unification fights. I've delivered opportunity to guys, but the energy hasn't been returned back to me for various reasons. But, you know, God is good at the end of the day. And with Joseph Parker, you know, I think highly of him. He's an amazing human being, you know, as a man. And he's a great fighter as well. And it's going to be a remarkable feeling to finally be able to share the ring with him once and for all.
Well, Deontay, I've heard you refer to your power as a blessing and a curse. What does that mean?
I mean, it's a blessing because I have the ability to knock a single man out with one punch. You know, this is something that's been with me all my life, not something that's just been developed. And the curse has been that I'm able to do that, it allow people to shy away from me, to become fearful of what may happen, you know, when they fight against me. And sometimes that can be harmful to the business of boxing. Because as fans, they just want to see the best fight the best, no matter what, win, lose, or draw. And that's what it should be about. All these fighters up here, we're all warriors. And I always said all the time, and I'll forever say it to the end of me, that we risk our lives for other entertainment. You know, and that right there is that in itself is just, you wouldn't know what it feels like unless you in as a fighter and get in the ring, you know. Many people talk what they talk and they say what they say, but until you able to get in the ring and see what that feels like and go through all the training and all the ups and downs what come with that and your personal life as well on top of that, it's a lot. It's a lot you have to deal with. It's a lot that you have to go through, But at the end of the day, man, you know, we do it for our fans. We do it for the love that we have for this business and to take care of our families.
One thing you said there, Deontay, you said about the power being a blessing and a curse. You said it's a curse because it can make other heavyweights shy away from you. Do you think any heavyweights on these two tables have ever shied away from a fight with Deontay Wilder?
You're so messy. But, you know, hey, I don't really have to say much. Y'all done heard me many times throughout the years, what I've been saying and what I've been talking about or whatever. So I don't think that I really have to necessarily just call out anything or point out any names or whatever, you know, at this moment in time. At this moment in time, my mind is solely set on Joseph Parker. That's it.
Shut your mouth.
that is a question that I actually have as well. Thank you, Derek Chisora. Do you plan on knocking out Joseph Parker? And if so, which round? And Joseph, you should be all ears here.
That's what I come to do, you know, and that's my only mission to come to do. When I look at the heavyweight division, that's what, you know, win is a good thing. It's just like basketball, you know. I can shoot threes, I can shoot twos, but it ain't nothing like a dunk for me. You know, everybody different. Everybody got their own, you know, personal thing that they like to do. But that's what I'm known for. And not just in boxing, in real life as well. You know what I mean? So I'm glad and I'm blessed to be able to bring it to something that means something. You know, it ain't just doing it for recreational. You know, we're doing it for a purpose, a reason. We all of us uplift people, we motivate, and we inspire people. And that's what I want to continue to do, to uplift, motivate, and inspire. And if anybody get inspiration off of me knocking people out and seeing that, the excitement, that's what I'm here to do, you know. I mean well for everyone, but we have a job to do at the end of the day.
One final thing, Deontay. Look, a fight that you have been linked to for so many years. I understand Joseph Parker is your next fight, but I can't ignore that I have yourself there and I have Anthony Joshua here, a fight that has been linked for so long. You talked about having to get a plane to come over here and speak to Anthony Joshua. Do you have anything to say to him here at this press conference table?
You know, it's good to be in the same room with him, to see him face to face, you know. It's been a long time coming. I wish you nothing but the best, bro. And hopefully soon we can get it on in the ring and get the people what they want, once and for all. But I wish you nothing but the best, even if it doesn't happen. But I believe it's gonna happen. I believe it will. It's about that time. But even if it don't, I wish you nothing but the best, nothing less.
Thank you, Deontay. Okay, let's finish up with Frank Warren. Frank, this has certainly whet the appetite here today. So many great fights coming up December 23rd. Give us your final thoughts.
Well, look, this is a magnificent card. You've got these warriors on here. You know, some of the best fighters in the world. A lot of big guys here. And this is what it's all about. This is what big-time boxing is all about. This is about giving the fights to the fans, making them happen. And they're happening. And from this, hopefully some other fights that the fans want to see will happen. We've got the two best heavyweights in the world are going to be fighting for the unifying the title fairly soon. And you'll hear more about that. In the meantime, you've got two guys here in Otto Wallin and in Joseph Parker who could upset the fight, well, I think, which is the next fight everybody wants to see. And that's AJ and Deontay. That's the fight we want to see, but will it get ruined? Are these guys going to ruin everybody's dream of seeing that fight? I know these two fighters definitely want it and want to get it on, so we will see. Everything is on the line with this. Everything is on the line. These are real, proper fights, proper challenges for everyone. And at the end of the day, as I always say, it'll be the fans who benefit. And His Excellency sitting over there, it is down to his vision, the vision that he had and the wherewithal to make this happen. And me as a boxing fan, I applaud him for it.
Thank you very much, Frank. Thank you to everyone who has joined us today and said their bit. And it's December 23rd. Did you want to say something else?
One more thing, and I would say this because I'm his dad. And George Warren, And as Eddie said earlier, he's been, and all the guys up here, he's worked very hard with the team behind the scenes, and he doesn't like too much getting up front. He should do, because he does more than I do, that's for sure. But anyway, this is going to be an event that everybody's going to be proud of, and he had a big part in it.
Thank you, Frank. Thank you, George, as well. December 23rd, it is unprecedented. It is historic. It is unrivaled.